Hey guys, this is Norm from SoundTraxx here with another video for y'all. Today we have the newly re-released Kato GS4 that we have put sound in, and today we're going to show you how to set it up. Alright, today we have an N-Scale Kato GS4 sitting here that we have just finished an install on. Install guides coming soon, both in written and video format. But today, what we're going to be doing is showing you how to set it up after the install. So, to start, we need to set our whistle. Now, this is obviously going to be CV120, and we have set CV120 to a value of 51. Now, CV51 is the classic 4449 whistle that I'm sure you all are familiar with. Next up is CV122, which is the bell. In this case, I've decided to leave it at the default, which is heavy brass 3 and a value of 27. Next up, we have CV123, which is the exhaust. In this case, I've chosen to go to set it to a value of 8, which is the third heavy exhaust probe on our decoders. And please note that we do have auto cylinder cocks enabled, so you will hear them right now. Next up, we have CV124, which is the air pump. Now, on the GS4, as you can see right here and here, we have dual cross-compound air pumps. Now, what I'm about to do is I'm about to tell it to chart the train line so you can hear what's going on. Now, closing out the values that can be found on our sound selection sheet online, which is under manuals in Tsunami2, we have the dynamo. Now, in this case, we have 1, 2, and 3 dynamos, so we will select triple dynamos, which is CV125 to a value of 7. Now, for most of the sounds up to this point, we have been using the sound selection reference, which can be found on soundtraxx.com under manuals. At this point, we are now going to move into the stuff that would be set up using the user's guide. In this case, we will be setting CV112 to a value of 10. Now, what that indicates is it indicates oil fired, non-lifting injector, power reverser, and a two-cylinder locomotive. Now, many of these sounds are going to run in the background as you run your trains. The oil atomizer will run primarily in the background, and you will primarily be able to hear it when you're stopped, as that the volume of the other sounds tends to be a lot lower at this time. Now, we also have a non-lifting injector, which is what feeds water into the boiler, as you can hear now. Now, next up, we have the power reverser selected, which sounds just like that, and will occur whenever you change direction. Now, finally being controlled by CV112, we have the cylinder count and the wheel slip. In this case, I have chosen to leave no wheel slip since we are not on an articulated locomotive, and I have set it to all those values to 0 so that we are only a two-cylinder, thus we get 4 chuffs per rotation. Now, I mentioned earlier that we do have the auto cylinder cocks enabled. That is done by setting a value of 8 into CV198, and then you will set the duration of the cylinder cocks in CV199. In this case, I've set it to 5, which represents 5 seconds. Now, one of the very interesting features about Tsunami decoders is that all of our function outputs can be remapped to do anything else. So in this case, I have a headlight and a Mars light. Now the Mars light, in this case, is set up to run from the what would normally be the tail light. However, I have the tail light set up on FX3, and I have configured all of that in CVs 49 through 51, as well as setting the directional control in CVs 57 and 58. Now, in this case, we have configured them so that the headlight, which is on the white wire in this case, has a value of 143, which indicates a dyno light, as well as LED compensation. The yellow output in this case, which is normally the tail light, has been configured to a value of 130, which is Mars light plus LED compensation. The tail light, which is on the green wire, in this case has been set also to 143 for dyno light plus LED compensation. Now, using our function mapping setup, I have actually set FX3 to work on the F0 key. Now, what we have also done is use CV 57 and 58 to determine which ones are on in which direction. In this case, headlight and Mars light are on in the forward direction, and the taillight is on in the rear direction. Now, for more information, you can go to soundtraxx.com, where you will find our user's guide detailing all of the various other features that you can set up with these decoders, as well as the ones I have touched on today. If you have any questions, you can contact us at support@soundtraxx.com. or via phone at 970-259-0690.